Welcome to the University of Rochester Pathology video series. This video reviews the normal histology of nerves. Using the NanoZoom digital pathology slides, available in the U of R Histology folder, we will examine the microscopic anatomy of nerves. Feel free to locate slide 19 and follow along as we explore the spermatic cord cross-section, which we will examine since there are abundant nerves in this region. The basic function of nerves is to provide communication between tissues across the body. Nerve cells come in many different forms, however, we will be focusing on the most common type, the neuron. A neuron consists of dendrites that receive neurotransmitters, a cell body that interprets these chemical signals, and an axon that delivers outgoing signals in the form of an action potential. Neurons are typically packed in bundles that together form the nerve. Let's take a look at this cross-section of spermatic cord at low power. Nerves can be identified as ovoid structures of wavy-looking cells, and even at low power we can see a number of these in our tissue section. All of the neurons comprising a nerve are usually surrounded by a layer of connective tissue called the epineurium, giving the nerve its cylindrical shape. Taking a closer look reveals that the neurons contained inside the epineurium are further grouped into even smaller bundles, known as fascicles. These fascicles are surrounded by another connective tissue covering called the perineurium. At high magnification, we can clearly see a number of nuclei within the fascicles. However, these nuclei do not belong to the neurons. They belong to the Schwann cells that encapsulate the axons of each neuron. The Schwann cells are rich in myelin and form a myelin sheath which acts to insulate the axon so that the action potential can propagate more quickly. This myelin sheath is in turn covered by the last surrounding layer of connective tissue, the endoneurium. The endoneurium separates each axon from each other and contains the endoneurial fluid, which serves to protect the neuron from harmful molecules in a similar way to the blood-brain barrier. Thus, in this cross-section, the most we can see of the neurons are the Schwann cells and endoneuriums surrounding their axons. The rest of the neuron, the cell body and dendrites, will not be found in this view of the peripheral nerve. These parts of the neuron typically cluster as well, relatively far from the axon terminal, in a group of cell bodies called ganglia. In this visual, we can see a large number of neural cell bodies grouped together in a large mass surrounded by small satellite cells. In summary, nerves are composed of bundles of neurons that are separated by connective tissue layers. The entire nerve is surrounded by the epineurium, and fascicles within the epineurium are surrounded by perineurium. The smallest connective tissue covering that encloses the myelin sheath of the axon is the endoneurium, which also holds the endoneurial fluid. Surrounding most axons of a neuron are Schwann cells that contain myelin that speed up the transfer of a chemical signal. The cell bodies of many neurons are clustered in groups called ganglia throughout the body. This concludes the review of normal nerve histology. Thank you for watching.